nitrogen. It's the most abundant gas in the air that we breathe. And if you didn't already know, liquid nitrogen is very cold, about 320 degrees below zero Fahrenheit cold. And today I'm gonna see if I can get a model rocket engine to burn while it's submerged in liquid nitrogen. And I'm not really worried about an explosion or fire or anything like that, simply because nitrogen is a very inert gas. But I am really curious to see what's going to happen when we have that cold liquid nitrogen come in contact with the rocket engine if it actually burns. Now, the way that I'm gonna set this up is pretty much identical to the way I set up the previous burning the model rocket engine videos. The only difference is this is a 2.5 gallon aquarium, and I think we're gonna have a lot of gas expansion that's happening. Waterproof and liquid nitrogen proof, maybe.
Oh, give it a second to equalize. Look at that boil. Oh, wow, that looks awesome. All right, before that gets too out of control, I'm gonna just ignite it.
Wow, it smells like sulfur. I'm thinking because I lit it up before the temperature equalized, it didn't blow the tank open like before. With the next aquarium, the insulated aquarium, I think we're gonna have a much different result, simply because I'm gonna wait, the temperature is gonna equalize completely, and then we're gonna light it. Here goes our insulated tank. This time I'm gonna burn the engine in an insulated tank. I'm gonna hook up the vacuum pump, pull a vacuum, so take out all the air and the space in between the two tanks, put the new rocket engine in there. In this case, since we don't have any air in between the two tanks, that's gonna act as pretty much an insulator. Hopefully, we'll get just the burn with the liquid nitrogen, and then we'll have complete chaos.
Oh yeah. Oh, I cracked that tank.
Godspeed, model rocket engine and liquid nitrogen. It didn't even blow up the tank. It only blew up that little tank. Wow, now we got a big tank and a little tank full of liquid nitrogen. Very interesting. Looks like it burned, but it didn't explode. I mean, it kind of exploded. I wanted complete chaos, but I didn't get it. Even though this was the insulated tank, we still had some frost. It was kind of obstructed. And that's our rocket engine. So let me pull that out, give you a closer look at our frozen model rocket. Yeah, this sucker's ice cold. Look at that. Yeah, I could barely hold it. It's so cold. And interestingly enough, that nozzle is still intact. Now, while that looked pretty cool, I really couldn't see the engine burning because the glass frosted up so quickly. It looks like the liquid nitrogen is just too cold. So what I'm going to do this time is I'm going to mount this insulated glass pack to the last tank that I have left. And my idea behind this is this should give us a nice insulated viewing window so we could see exactly what's going on when the rocket engine burns in liquid nitrogen. This time, I'm going to leave the rocket engine in the liquid nitrogen for a couple minutes, giving the rocket engine a chance to reach the same temperature as the liquid nitrogen, and then I'm going to ignite it. Surprisingly, that experiment led to some very interesting results. The first thing that I noticed is that the whole rocket engine burned in like 3 seconds flat. And this reminded me a lot of when I burned the model rocket engine in a vacuum. It behaved very similar. The whole rocket engine just burned in like 3 seconds, and this one did the same thing. I don't know why that is. Maybe you can tell me, but that's what happened. Second thing that I noticed is that this whole casing just cracked. I thought this was just some kind of like soot or dirt, but upon further inspection, the thing is actually cracked. So I don't know if that was from the pressure because the casing was so cold or what happened there. The third thing that happened that I found very interesting, and I also learned something myself, is how effective double pane glass really is. The liquid nitrogen is more than 300 degrees below zero, and we didn't even have fog on the outside pane of that double pane glass pack. That shows me how well that double pane glass insulates, because you have almost a 300 degree temperature difference from the outside pane to the inside pane, and we didn't even get any fog. This wasn't really what I wanted, but I think it was cool. I think it showed us that a rocket engine definitely burns in liquid nitrogen.